Good afternoon, welcome to the Daily Office, and thanks for joining me. This is evening prayer for Sunday, December 21st. It's the fourth Sunday in Advent, and the scripture for this service, Psalm 84, and John chapter 3, verse 16 to 21, and a canticle from Isaiah chapter 45, verse 17 and 18, and 22 through 25. And please join me in singing verse 6 of O Come, Emmanuel.
O come, thou dayspring from on high, and cheer us by thy drawing nigh. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night, and this dark shadow put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
O God, come to my assistance, make haste to help me. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. How lovely is your dwelling place, O God of hosts. Psalm 84. And please recite it together with me. How lovely is your dwelling place, O God of hosts. My soul longs for your courts. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. The sparrow has found herself a home, and the swallow a nest. She lays her young beside your altars, O God of hosts, my ruler and my God. Blessed are they that dwell in your house. They forever praise you. Blessed are they whose strength is in you, in whose hearts are the roads to Zion, who passing through the bitter valley make it a well. The rain fills the pools. They go from strength to increasing strength, every one of them in Zion, seeing God. O Most High God of hosts, hear my prayer. Give ear, O God of Jacob, Leah, and Rachel. Behold, O God, our shield, and look on the face of your anointed. For a day in your courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a servant in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of the wicked. For you, God, are sun and shield. You give grace and glory. No good thing will you withhold from them that walk uprightly. Blessed are they that trust in you. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. How lovely is your dwelling place, O God of hosts. A lesson from the Holy Gospel according to John, chapter 3, beginning at verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God. Here ends the lesson. And now let us offer our prayers and petitions, and please say the response after each verse. Show us your mercy, O God, and grant us your salvation. Let your priests be clothed with righteousness, and let your saints shout for joy. In you shall we lie down in peace and sleep, for only you make us dwell in safety. Make us a righteous nation that keeps your truth, that we may glory in your judgment. Let your way be known upon the earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor perish forever. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and renew a right spirit within us, and for all of your intentions. Together. Our beloved, which art in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive others. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Let's say the canticle together. But Israel shall be saved by God Most High with an everlasting salvation. You shall not be ashamed nor confounded to all eternity. For thus says our God that created the heavens, look to me and be saved, all the ends of the earth. For I am God, there is no other. Unto me every knee shall bow and every tongue shall swear. And only in me are righteousness and strength, and to me all people shall come. And all that are incensed against me shall be ashamed, and in me all the children of Israel shall be justified and glory. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Bless Jesus, my soul, and may the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.